This video is sponsored by Skillshare. In this video, I am going to show you guys how to create a very cool and unique looking text animation inside of DaVinci Resolve. I am Vikash from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more interesting videos, and let's do some basic setting and get started. So click on this setting button and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can go with 4K as well. And here we have to set the frame rate. So in this case, I am using the 30 frame per second, which is a normal frame rate. But if you want a smooth animation, then you can go with 60 frame per second as well. And click on save. Now I'm going to create this animation inside of this Fusion page. So we have to take a new Fusion composition. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on this new Fusion composition. You can call it anything, it doesn't really matter. Set the duration of this composition maybe 5 seconds long, frame rate 30, click on create. Now just drag this Fusion comp on this timeline just like that, and just set it like this, and just go to your Fusion page. And here we get this media out, so just drag this media out node to the side for now, and let's start by taking a new text node. So click on this T icon to add a text node on this flow window. Just drag this text to the viewer, close this media pool, and after that we have to type our first text over here. Now we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I am using this Go Bold font style, which is my favorite font style. And of course, you can select any different font style that you want. And we have to increase the size of this text. So I'm going to set this value something around 0.16 maybe. All right, it's looking perfect. Now just right click on this preview window, go to guide and turn on this guide for a reference, and hit control and scroll up to zoom in and set it like this. And after that we have to create a shape node. So what we have to do, we have to take a new blank page. So for that I'm gonna use this background node and just drag this background to the viewer, hit F2 on the keyboard, call it shape. Hit OK. Just select this shape layer, click on this rectangle tool to add a rectangle node with this shape layer. Select this rectangle one and let's set this height value something around 0.08. Now it's looking perfect, and after that we have to merge this shape layer with this text. So we have to take a new merge node. So just drag this merge on this flow window, and here we get four different points. So the yellow point is for background, green is for foreground, and this blue point is for effect mask, and this is the output. So I'm gonna use this shape as a foreground, text as a background. So I'm gonna connect this yellow point with this text one and green foreground point with this shape, and just drag this merge one to the viewer, and after that select this rectangle one and set it like this. And now we have to select a nice and simple gradient color for this shape. So select this shape node, go to inspector window, and here we have this type. So change this solid color to gradient, and we will get two different color point. So select this first color point, click on this box and select any color. So I'm gonna use this pink. Click on OK. Select this second point, click on this color box and select this red color, hit OK. And now we have this nice and simple gradient color. All right, and after that we have to create one more text over here. So just take one more text node on this flow window, and we have to merge this second text with this main output. So either you can connect this output with this main output and we will get this new merge, or you can just drag and drop this merge node on this flow window and connect it like this. Alright, just drag this merge to the viewer, type your second text over here. And for this one, I'm gonna go with Gotham font style. Alright, and now just drag this text right over here. Let's down the size a bit. So I'm gonna set this value something around 0.05. Hit control and scroll up to zoom in and just set this text in the center of this shape layer. Before we proceed further, let me tell you, this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where a million come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on the topic, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Skillshare offers creative classes designed for real life and all the circumstances that comes with it. These lessons can help you to stay inspired, express yourself, and introduce you to a community of millions. You can check out this course, Brand Management on Skillshare by Chris Ballman. In this course, join Chris Ballman to learn how to define and develop 6 core brand pillars that will set your brand apart. Skillshare is also very affordable for everyone. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. And the best thing is that the first 1,000 people to use the link given in the description will get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership. Just go to the link in the description and check this out. And after that, we have to animate these text. So what we have to do, just select this rectangle one first. Go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 30 FPS. And here we have this width. So right click on width, click on animate, and go to very first frame of this animation. And let's down this width value and set it like this. And now we will get this type of animation. All right. And now we have to animate the second text as well. So select this text too. And here we have this tracking. So initially we have to set this tracking value something around 1.3, and right click on tracking, click on animate, or you can also click on this timing button right over here, and then go to very first frame of this animation, and I'm gonna set this tracking value something around 0.5, and now we will get this type of animation, as you can see. All right, and now we have to animate this main text. So select this text one, go to on frame number 90, which is equal to 3 seconds. Go to layout, and here we have this center. So right click on center, click on animate, and go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second, and we have to drag this text right over here, just like this. And now we will get this type of animation, but I want to hide this extra part. So what we have to do, we have to take a rectangle tool, and I'm going to attach this rectangle to with this text effect mask. All right. And I'm going to set this outline of this rectangle right over here, just like this. You can increase the width as well. And after that, I'm gonna hide this part. So we have to invert the rectangle mask. So just select this rectangle tool, check this option invert. And now it's looking perfect. Now we have to make this animation smoother because this is a linear animation right now. So just go to a spline window, check this option text one first, click on fit button, select both the keyframes, click on smooth, set the CTI right over here, hold this handle and just drag it like this. All right, uncheck this text one, check this rectangle one, click on fit, select these both keyframes, click on smooth button or hit S on the keyboard. Set the CTI at very beginning of this animation, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice and smooth curve. Uncheck this rectangle one, check this text two, click on fit, select both the keyframes, click on smooth, hold this handle and just drag it like this. And now we have nice and simple smooth animation. Close this spline window. And after that, I want to create a time gap between this shape and the text. So what we have to do, just go to spline window and Select this text tool only, click on fit, select both the keyframe, and let's drag the keyframe 10 frame forward in time. So just go to on frame number 10, hold this point, hold shift on the keyboard and just drag it like this. And now we have a time gap of 10 frame between this shape and the text. All right. And let's do one more thing. Just go to very beginning of this animation and hide this white section for a moment. So just go to on frame number 15, select this second text, go to setting tab, and here we have this opacity. So right click on opacity, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation and let's down the opacity and set it to 0. And now we will get this type of effect, as you can see. And after that, we have to attach a transform node. So just select this merge to output, click on this transform button, drag this transform to the viewer, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, and this is going to be our controller. So let's call it controller, hit OK. And now we can control the size of this whole animation. You can control the position, but I'm gonna leave it as it is. All right, and after that, we have to connect this media out with this main output and then go to your edit page. And now we have this nice and simple text animation for your project. And you can use this text animation on any background that you want. All right, and now let's take a look. So click on this loop button, go to very first frame, and let's take a look. All right, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.